developments in efforts to make peace with the Taliban. The U.S. sending a senior envoy to Kabul for talks with Afghan government leaders, hoping to bring the Taliban to the negotiating table and end the 17-year war. Lucas Tomlinson, live from the Pentagon with more. Lucas.
Good morning, John. Sunday marked 17 years to the day the first U.S. combat troops entered Afghanistan. Now, nearly two decades later, the violence remains unrelenting. Late last week, the top U.S. general for Afghanistan and the region said that casualties to the U.S.-trained Afghan army are increasing and higher this year compared to last year, following what he called a bloody summer. And late last week, the Pentagon identified the U.S. Army soldier killed by a roadside bomb in southern Afghanistan's Helmand province. 23-year-old Army Specialist James Slape of Morehead City, North Carolina, died after stepping out of his vehicle Thursday to render assistance to another vehicle also hit by a roadside bomb. Specialist Slape's body returned home to Dover Air Force Base Saturday. His death marked the seventh American killed in action this year. The deadliest year in Afghanistan was 2010, following then-President Obama's surge, which put over 100,000 American troops in Afghanistan. But today, there are roughly 15,000 American troops in Afghanistan, much fewer compared to 7 years ago. About half are focused on the counterterrorism mission, the other training Afghan forces. Violence continued over the weekend, the Taliban destroying bridges outside Kabul on the same day President Trump's new envoy for peace in Afghanistan, Zalmay Khalilzad, arrived in Kabul ahead of Afghan parliamentary elections next week. The Taliban are urging a boycott. Khalilzad is the former ambassador to Afghanistan and later Iraq during the George W. Bush administration. The U.S. military has doubled its airstrikes in Afghanistan this year compared to last. The violence ahead of the elections makes peace with the Taliban increasingly difficult, John.
And America's longest war goes on. Lucas Tomlinson, thank you.